Welcome to Ask the AstroShaman number 4. It's April 2nd, 2019. I'm Benjamin Bernstein with AstroShaman.com. Today we have two fairly brief questions, one about the location of the Galactic Center and the other about a person who, in listening to my East program that I do with my partner Makisla, keeps nodding out during parts of it, and I've had a lot of people report that. So it'll be a fairly brief video and I can answer these questions pretty concisely. First, Bruce wrote, "Thank you for sharing your light and wisdom. I appreciate it. I have a question about the Galactic Center and where it is. Recently, I heard an astrologer say it would be at 2 degrees of Libra on the next full moon. I'm just starting to explore astrology, and I thought it was at 26 Sagittarius. I'm curious because I have my sun at 2 Libra, etc., and wants to take full advantage of the opportunity. Thanks. Thanks and light, Bruce." Well, actually, right now, if you use Western astrology, then the Galactic Center is now at 27 degrees Sagittarius, and it only moves 1 degree every 72 years. So it ain't gonna be anywhere near to Libra anytime soon. Just a standard word of warning, anyone can say anything online, and there's probably as much false information out there as true. So just take everything you hear with a grain of salt, and if it's important, you might wanna fact check it. Don't just believe the first source you read. I've just been stunned at some of the blatantly false information I've read about astrology on the web. I try to be as accurate as I can, but who knows, I might make a mistake once in a while and not even know it. So that was a quick answer to Bruce's question. Now I'm going to lean forward and scroll my screen and get to the next one. This is a question about ease ceremonies. And I should clarify that ease is a program that my partner Makisla and I offer for free. You can get to it at astroshaman.com and go to services. And then a few items down, ease, embodied awakening support experience, free. And we actually give it away free, and we take donations to help finance it, but you're never required to pay anything. So basically, it's a weekly event that I'll tell you more about in a sec, but let me get to his question, or her question actually, because this is from Erica. She writes, "I was tuned into your last shamanic ceremony. Today I heard a different shamanic ceremony from your archives. I should mention we archive all our events right now. We're up to 185 recordings, all of which are free to access, stream, or download once you join." She says, "Thank you for sharing the ceremonies. It's helpful to stay clear and fortify the embodied awakening. It is a practice. Thank you." She's referring, embodied awakening is the invocation that is used in many East calls where you just call in your divine self into your human self and they blend together and give you a vastly more wonderful human experience than you get when you're not blended. She says, "Also nice to see your beloved one in your home and feel the harmony." She's referring to Makisla, who usually does the ease calls with me. "I have a question about the healing part. Both times I zoned out a bit. Last week I think I completely checked out, snoozed. Today I was outside in daylight and I still had many disconnections, seeing some flashbacks like many dreams coming back and forth from breath awareness consciously. Any idea what is happening? I appreciate your feedback. I wonder if I need to do anything about this tendency. Again, thank you for sharing the invocations and ceremonies at your home with us remotely, Erica." So let me speak broadly too. This phenomenon is not exclusive to our ease program. My understanding of what's happening, and I've been through this myself many times in a ceremonial context or a meditation context, where you hit a certain level and it's about as far as your consciousness can go right now and still stay awake at the human level. And so the human part of you passes out or sleeps or zones out. There is a part of you that is conscious in that level, building up the ability to hold awareness there eventually, but the human part is not quite ready and it falls asleep. I remember one rather dramatic ayahuasca ceremony years ago, not dramatic like fireworks, but notable because I kept waking up and passing out, waking up, passing out, waking up. I'd get to some really intense moment and blah, gone. And I realized, oh, the next thing I know, I'm coming awake again to the ceremony and an undetermined amount of time has passed. And that happened several times in that ceremony. And my understanding of what was happening was that, again, something was happening that was simply too intense for Benjamin to experience at that time. And so Benjamin had to be put under spiritual anesthesia briefly. The process would complete and then Benjamin could wake back up and continue his conscious participation. And I think that is what's happening. I've had a lot of people report, you know, I'm falling asleep during the ease calls, et cetera, what's going on? And I think this is what's happening. Of course, it's possible you're just tired and your fatigue wins over your consciousness and you just sleep because you need sleep. But I think more commonly that it's the ego's not quite ready to experience that yet. It's put under anesthesia. Something happens in the inner world. You come back and you wake up again. And eventually, if you persevere, you will develop the ability to hold consciousness in whatever state has been passing you out. As far as the flashbacks and such, she says, outside in daylight, still had many disconnections, seeing some flashbacks like many dreams. Again, consciousness is a mysterious thing. And sometimes as you're working with something, it may reoccur to you in just in regular consciousness. And that's not a bad thing. It's just being processed, worked on in various ways by the various levels of your own consciousness. And that's nothing to worry about. It's not like an LSD flashback where it's traumatic or difficult. It's just awareness of little things happening. So I didn't sense from Herika's email that these were a problem, but just a notable event. So your consciousness and subconscious will work together in whatever way is going to serve highest good for you to integrate and achieve different levels of consciousness. So that's basically my answer to Herika's question. Again, if you're intrigued by the EASE program and not already a part of it, again, it is free. There's no catch. You just go to astroshaman.com, services, EASE currently is the fourth one down, and click in there. You'll see a long description of it with some places you can plug in your name and email. If you sign up, you'll get 2 emails a week, one the morning of the event as a reminder, and then usually that night or the next day when the MP3 is up, I'll send you an email, the MP3 is up, here's how to get to it, and here's next week's event. And we'll describe what the following one is like. We have a variety of events that we do. What they have in common is they're going to help you with your healing, your spiritual awakening, and your ability to move in the inner worlds and, you know, serve others, serve the collective, benefit yourself. So there's some events that are much more structured and there's a definite dynamic they follow. Others are very free form and we just set our stage energetically and then we just see what happens. And the dozens of allies that we call in when we start are beautiful at guiding us. So anyhow, that's a sense of it. You can check it out if you like. If you ever join and get tired of it, you can just one click unsubscribe and you'll never get another EASE email. So it's available if you wish. My partner, Makisla, and I are very big on helping people wake up, and that's why it's there. So, that's it for Ask the Astro Shaman number 4. Thanks for watching.